For the last one now, we want to be green if the number is bigger than whatever's in here, and red if it's less than. And note, we don't have an option for what's equal to. So let's just go there, conditional formatting, go to the icons. You'll notice that my ups and downs is always the yellow option as well. So let's just choose that for now. Again, we need to go manage the rules. And you'll see Excel automatically does the percent. We're going to change it to a number and a number. And we're going to say be green when you're bigger than or equal to. And I'm going to link it to the cell here. Then it says be yellow when you're less than zero, whatever's in there. And we're actually going to link to the exact same thing. So we're going to say look there. When I say OK and apply, you'll see that this happens, and notice there's no yellow. And that's because the way conditional formatting works is if it's bigger than or equal to whatever's in there, the 14, it automatically turns green. Only if that's not true does it actually go to these other steps. So what you can do is, if I refer to the same reference point, it actually ignores this one. So then we've just got an up and a down. In this example, we've got a budget and actual. We want to see what the variance is, but it's quite hard to see negatives and positives here. So what we want is colored arrows, green up if it's gone up, red down if it's gone down. The solution to this example, we highlight the variances, conditional format. We're going to put the icons on. When you use this one, the up, down, and orange, you'll see at the moment they all seem to be very red. The reason being is notice that we've got a massive number here. By default, what Excel does is it uses the percent. Keep in mind it's not the percent you see here. This percent looks at the smallest number, the biggest number, and refers to 67% of that range. So in this case, we actually want to change both of these to numbers, because remember, a percentage is actually just a number. And we're going to say it must be green when the value is bigger than or equal to zero, so I'm happy with that. When it's less than zero or bigger than and equal to zero, so we're actually going to change this to be just bigger than, because we want it to do this when it's zero and red when it's negative. Apply it, and what you'll see now looks a bit better. The positives are green, zeros are orange, and reds are negative.